Okay, so this is Super Ghouls and Ghosts, one of my all-time favorite games. Gonna try and do a good run for you guys. This is actually the first game I ever had on the Super. I remember getting it in the $5 bin, the on sale bin at Walmart. And I played the heck out of it when I was a kid. So sometimes I can no-death run it, but not always, because it's still pretty tough, even if you're good. The way the enemies spawn, you can just get like a really bad run sometimes. One of the worst things that can happen is if you get a bad weapon. There's only really two weapons I like, either this dagger or the arrows. Actually, I prefer the arrows, but the dagger's alright. Now that I'm all powered up, I don't need to get any more chests. There's another chest right there, but I don't need it. Hopefully my mic is working this time. I did a really good run the other day where I got almost all the way through without even getting hit, and then when I watched the playback, my mic wasn't working. Thank you. okay, so far so good, but this is actually one of the hardest levels right here because it's on rails. Nice thing about that magician is at least it doesn't take away your power-ups. Another nice thing is this weapon is actually really good for this level, because you have a lot of little enemies. It's really good for this boss coming up. But still, this boss is one of the hardest bosses in the game, so you never know if you might get hit anyway because he has random stuff that he shoots. Ooh, that was a good run. This weapon is also good for this next level, because there's these little orange dudes that fly low that are good to hit from this weapon. Those little orange dudes. Thank you. This part's really hard because it's got these really tricky jumps. Here's the first error. Which, I made that look easy, but he's actually really hard if you don't have a good weapon. Now, I kinda wanna get those arrows. I think I will. The arrows can be tricky though, because on this level you get these bats coming out of nowhere, and if the arrow misses them, sometimes you don't have time to shoot again. And these dudes are really tough too, because they just fall randomly. Sometimes they'll fall right on your head. Oh, I got lucky right there. That was a pretty good run. Okay, now this level is usually one of the harder levels because it's got these genie dudes that spawn in really bad spots. See, that was bad right there. Not only do they fly kind of randomly, but they spawn in really bad places. This next part is really hard. Okay, those jumps right there are some of the hardest jumps in the game. And now this is the other on rails part, which is really, really probably one of the hardest levels. Because you have these. All this stuff that kind of spawns randomly. Like these little blue dudes are the worst. Well, that was kind of lucky. Usually there's a dude right there, but there wasn't. See, that's the funny thing about this game, is even if you've played it a million times, the enemies are pretty random, so it's like different every time. Okay, we're looking pretty good here. This boss can fool you sometimes though. This boss is funny because it has a lot of slowdown. Okay, pretty good run so far. There's a chest right there, but I don't need it. Woo! Gotta watch out for that guy. See, he doesn't always give you a hard time right there. A lot of times I get by him without even having to jump right there. There's another chest right there that I don't need. But it's good to know where all the chests are, because if you do get hit, you want the chests. That was pretty close. This section is pretty tough because you got a lot of random stuff. These icicles can get you really. Get a lot of slowdown too. I think there's another chest right there, but I don't need it. Here's an armor. Got it. Without the homing arrows, he's really, really hard to hit. two chests back there that I don't need. See right there, the arrows didn't want to cooperate and hit him for me. There's a way right here that you can ride on that avalanche and actually gain invincibility. It's like a glitch. Oh no! Got lucky. See, that's what happens if the avalanche hits you. That was weird. Usually you get another avalanche right there. See, I'm getting like some weird spawns in this run. It gave me one early avalanche and then one avalanche didn't even show. Those things are nasty. That boss can really get you sometimes if you're not careful. Okay, now this level has two Aramers, which... Of course, my arrows aren't even hitting him. Okay, got one of them. If you don't have the homing arrows or like a gold suit right here, it's really hard. Okay, got him. That was pretty lucky. And there's actually a third one coming up. This could be, this level is the level that just stops a lot of people because of those air mirrors. If you don't have the homing missiles, it can be really hard to get past them. There's another chest right there that I just ran by it. All you have to do is like jump in a certain way in there. Pretty good run. Of course, now I think we're on the last level, which is, again, one of the hardest levels. gonna bother me. Okay. Those little blue dudes can really be the death of you. This guy in particular, what I usually do is drop like that because he gets you a lot of time. This guy right here too. Oh, see, that's weird. Usually there's another guy right there. Okay, here comes another Aramer. This part is hard right here. There's these two birds that can really screw with you. Whew, not too bad. This part can be hard just because of all these stupid ghosts. Alright, last boss right here. Actually, the homing arrows are not really good for this guy. They don't like to hit him. Whoa, that was close. Now this guy. Almost got him. His flame goes much farther, if you haven't noticed. That's the only difference, but his charge beam thing is actually easier to avoid. That was where he shot the frame twice. There we go. I think that was a no-death run. Was that a no-death run? And of course, you know, you guys who know this game know that it's notorious because you actually have to beat it twice to get the true ending. But I never do that. I just consider this as beating it. Because it makes you, it's kind of dumb, but you know why they did it, because it's like in these old school games, they wanted you to get the most replay value. But yeah, if you want the true, true ending, you have to play through all the way through again and beat it again. And not only that, but beat it with the worst weapon in the game, which is this bracelet thing that... See, she's talking about the bracelet. It's like the worst weapon in the game. It has no range at all, which makes this last boss really hard, because it's like really hard to even get close to him without a ranged weapon. But yeah, so I never do that though. I never play it twice. I just consider this beating it. And there you go. I'm calling that a no-death run. Pretty cool deal, guys, so. Alright, we'll catch you next time. Mark the Martian, over and out.